It says here in Isaiah 41:11, "Look, all those getting enraged against you will be put to shame and humiliated. Those who fight with you will be brought to nothing and perish. You will search for men who struggle with you, but you will not find them. The men at war with you will become as something as non-existent, as nothing at all. For I, Jehovah your God, am grasping your right hand, the one saying to you, do not be afraid, I will help you."
Complex ambition.
They gonna love me for my ambition. Beautiful music, painted pictures, this be my vision.
Welcome everybody, today we're bringing you another segment of Complex Ambition Reactions Reviews, Ariana Grande. But first, sound!
My name is YI.
My name is Maloon.
And man, today, man, probably gonna get a little jokes here and there, you know what I'm saying? That's what we do, especially when it comes to this
Ariana.
You know what I'm saying? But it's all in good taste. Whatever taste you want. Whatever taste you want. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, man.
But it's Ariana Grande. She has this major album. It's called Sweetener. Just like the sweetener, I guess, you put in your coffee, like sugar.
Yeah, Splenda.
We all have our own sweetener. Some people use maple.
Some people use men.
Yeah, I guess. Interesting rollout because, you know, I forgot that she had an album coming, you know. I really forgot, but definitely not the rest of the world did it, because this fucking breaking numbers, doing everything's the biggest shit in the world.
That feels like number two right now.
Yo, no, that's Nicki.
Hell no.
That's Nicki, bro.
That's Nicki, baby.
That's Nicki. That's another segment as well.
We reacted to her album,
Yo,
Queen.
Go check out the Queen album, you know what I'm saying? But her album was supposed to come out the 18th, but I guess this is the reason why she didn't do it. Because she wanted to give...
Because she wants to let Nicki Minaj shine, because she's tripping.
No. Nicki wanted to let Ariana shine, you know what I'm saying? Because they're on some sister-friendly shit, you know what I'm saying? They've been close recently. So she wanted to give Ariana her own week or her own shine, you know what I'm saying? Rightfully so, because they are two big major female artists, you know what I'm saying? But we have here Ariana with Sweetener, man, and we have 15 tracks. A couple of them, I believe two of them you heard already.
Right?
We reacted to Ain't Got No Tears Left to Cry. Very majestic, very melodic, you know what I'm saying? God as a Woman, we didn't react to it, but that shit went crazy. The video, a lot of stuff that's happening with that, you know what I'm saying? God as a Woman. You believe God as a woman. She's performing that tonight at the VMAs, you know what I'm saying? So go check that out if you haven't, if it's already up by now, whatever. I'm gonna put a little clip. But, I'm kind of excited because, bullshit aside, She's very talented. I would say
the nigga,
she could be the best female singer out right now when it comes to skill wise. Her vocal ability. Because her vocal ability, even when it comes to the little shit she does with Jimmy Fallon when she's on the show, when she does imitations of voices, she's spot on.
They're sweet and strange, finding you can jam.
When she was younger, she was classically trained.
Yo, her Celine Dion is amazing. Spot on. It's almost like it's a Celine Dion. You know what I'm saying? I think in the future, when it comes to that, she probably will be like known for like being like on that level of a Celine Dion level.
No, I swear to God, no.
For our generation,
The thing is with her is that in everything that she's done, if you think about it, it's always been about her voice. You feel me?
Even
when
she was like,
what was she on? Disney, right?
Yeah.
Nickelodeon.
Even her talking
voice is
weird.
She was on something, but a lot of times it was just her singing, you feel me? That was what really made her shine. I don't know. I don't think she would ever be compared
to Celine Dion. Ever. Ever, ever. Because of the category she's in, though, she's pop. So, her music doesn't highlight her voice. That's the thing. That's why people think that she doesn't sing as well as she could. Because her music, pop music, is not highlighting...
Yeah,
maybe there's a genre that she's in, Simply Said.
So, I think I just love her a lot.
Yeah, maybe.
No, I fuck with her.
Maybe.
I fuck with her.
Very excited for one track that's supposedly called Pete Davidson. So,
Jesus Christ.
We're gonna kick off with that right there.
Oh my God.
And I've been on my shit. Last night I was watching a lot of shit. You know what I'm saying? She said that 3 years ago she said that she was gonna marry him already.
We met on SNL and I like 2-3 years ago or when I left, and I like jokingly said to my tour manager, I was like, I'm marrying him 100%. I'm literally marrying him.
You know what I'm saying? That's kind of,
what's so special about
this dude?
It's cute,
right? It's cute, but baby girl, hold up. 3 years ago? That doesn't, that, you were in a relationship and shit. So you were already plotting on a nigga when you were another nigga? You know what I'm saying? Like, that's very, I feel bad for my nigga Mac, man.
I don't feel bad. My nigga, have you seen his NPR Tiny Desk concert?
No, he's shining.
That nigga's shining.
He's shining.
That nigga's shining.
He's shining.
He's shining. Damn, he got a smile on crest.
That's
he's shining.
He's shining.
That's how you know that, like, damn, love is, like love is really blind then.
Yo.
Nigga, love nothing. It's called infatuation.
I wish you good luck. When we get into that track, we're going to see what the fuck that track's about.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't want to let, like, anything, like...
She's giving me headache.
Made me go bias.
Bro, yeah, but, like, she was a Mac though.
I feel like Angela Yee.
I feel like a bitch. I feel like a bitch. But all I know, I'm not gonna talk about Ariana because I don't know her situation. But all I know is that Mac shining. His teeth are crust, baby. You
go pick up that swimming album out now. Review out now.
The nigga's shining.
He's shining. He might win a Grammy. He's shining.
He's shining.
He's shining.
He's shining.
You know what I'm saying?
He's shining.
Y'all didn't work out, but he's shining.
He's shining.
A lot of production from Pharrell on this album. I think he's actually executive produced it as well with another executive producer. So that's very interesting.
That's interesting.
That's dope.
Amazing.
You know what I'm saying? The first track, Raindrops, subtitled Angel Cried. The day you left me, oh, she cried.
Like,
I teared up. I'm not bullshitting.
Wow.
And that was the intro. That was 30 seconds long.
My eyes got slightly watery.
Yo.
That was great.
I was about to break out. I was trying to see where my niggas was at mentally. Before.
Hey. Yeah. Keep it playing,
nigga,
bro.
Nigga, what?
That was good. Fuck. I'm going to put that shit on repeat.
Nigga, I might have to. How long is it? How long was that shit?
30 seconds.
Let's put that shit again.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
PD. Fuck that guy. When I see you, I'm gonna propose to you on the spot.
We can't do girl albums with this guy.
Yeah. Because
he gets so riled. Yeah. He wants to fuck them all.
Yeah. No, not that at all. Not that at all, but like.
She's tiny, bro. You gotta be careful.
No, I loved her when I was younger. I had a crush on her. When she had the red hair.
She's dope,
what was it?
Bro.
Was it
I find it.
No. Victoria Justice?
Like, I have no idea.
She had
I don't
a show.
Know what she was on.
One of the shows.
She was on one of those things.
I loved her. I was like, oh my God, I love this girl.
She's dope.
She's
like I find her to be really
Selena
dope.
Selena Gomez, I like Selena.
No, I like Selena Gomez.
Anyways, man.
She was too tiny for me. I feel like I'll break her.
Oh, God. No.
She's tiny, bro. I can't handle that. I mean, she can handle. I mean.
Track 2.
Man. Track 2.
Man. Blaze.
Track 2.
Man. Featuring Pharrell Williams.
There is something between us.
That we have Pharrell. Pharrell always staying relevant.
He always will stay relevant.
You'll catch that nigga on a Big Trouble Baby. On a Trouble album. And then you'll catch him on an Ariana album. That's one of the only niggas you can say that.
No, absolutely. He's the most versatile human being maybe alive.
Yo. And that nigga can wear a dress. And he can wear Tim's. He can, it's everything.
He's
everything.
About him. He's multidimensional, bro.
That nigga's an alien, bro.
I swear to God, he's like 10 years old sometimes. And then sometimes
he's
49. He's like 100 years old at times and 10 years old at other times. I don't know what's going on, man. The guy looks ageless.
No. That's dumb.
I don't even know if he had parents.
I don't want to meet him. I don't want to meet him.
That nigga must...
I want to, but I don't want to.
He must do Neutrogena. He's not meant to be for Mac. And that's a good thing for Mac, to not be with a person that's not meant to be with her. And that's it. You know, that's reality.
You want Pete, baby? I don't want you.
Yeah. Go ahead.
You want me? I don't want you.
Go ahead.
You just gotta keep rolling.
I love love.
Featuring Nicki Minaj, this was a single out as well.
Light is coming to give back everything the darkness stole.
Shout out to Nicki, the queen. It's definitely like some Pharrell shit.
It's one me, now I'm the bad guy. Call me Chun-Li. Cause you was slipping, yep, you clumsy. Now we shooting a shot like drive-by. Why you had to make me go call up my side guy? You're Ariana, call let me get you a high five. I'm gonna give back everything the darkness stole.
That's for real,
coming to give back everything that darkness don't.
The beat was great.
Pharrell was in his bag real quick. The beat was fantastic. I felt like,
I felt like that song was really basic.
It was, I think it's appeals to the younger audience. I think it's a little formula,
well,
man.
Shit, I'm young.
Yeah, buddy. I'm talking about, bro, like, I'm talking about 11, 14. 12. You know what I'm saying?
Next track, R.E.M. Ren. This is her favorite track off the album.
What their favorite song is. R.E.M.
Mm-hmm. Her favorite track. Yeah, her favorite track.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? Rem, like Rem's sleeping, I believe. You know what I'm saying? If you know about that, if you don't, do your Googles, baby.
I like it.
Wow. She loves that man, you know?
She don't want to wake up. She's really in love, though. That's what I'm getting so far. That's what I'm getting in so far. She's really in love. She's in a deeper type of love, though.
Yeah, man.
This is like when niggas discover fried chicken and shit.
Yeah.
This is a different type of love.
Oh, my God.
This is a different type of love.
Wow. I hope he's good to her.
She don't want to wake up.
She don't want to wake up, bro.
That's deep.
That nigga better bring flowers and shit to her. Nigga, I swear to God, I'm crying a little bit. Because it's like, nigga's like...
That's real love, yo.
Nigga!
That nigga passing blunts to her.
You better stop that shit, Petey.
I feel like that man can see through his eyelids.
Yeah. What the fuck?
Yeah, it gives me that vibe, right?
Bro,
see
like,
through his eyelids.
Like,
man's mad.
That nigga's the next Spider-Man.
Could have sworn he was albino.
Next track we have is God is a Woman. You guys heard it before. If you have it, we're gonna vibe out a little to it and also show clips of the video. You believe God is a
woman. Why not?
Show.
Cause why not?
That was kind of Mac's whole theme for his last album.
I love her hair.
Divine feminine, God being a woman, and like godly women.
She looks good.
She looks fantastic.
She looks amazing.
Place in New York. Alright. I like it.
It's a good track.
I like that.
It's a pretty hard track. That's why I did what it did, them numbers. You know what I'm saying?
I like that track. I like that. The first one. Other ones have been, I don't know. Because when I think about her, I'm thinking about going hard like this. Them vocals going hard.
That's, like this.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay.
Like, oh, wow. That's what I expect from her. Not like no, just regular.
Yeah. Regular. Pete must be a good guy, though.
Oh,
like,
my God. Put the next track.
He must be, like, he must be, he has to be a good guy.
Yeah, title track, Sweetener. When life deals us good, then it's sweet, then you ought to bring the
better day. Hit it, 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 hit it,
Take Sweetener. It was one that was the bowl right there. Look at this one. I like the way you look the bowl. You look the bowl. Somehow your methods touched my soul. It lifts me up to heights unknown. So when they ask, how's life? I go, sheesh. Bro, where's Pete's eating the box. Fuck.
And then you go.
Wait, hold up.
Get it.
What?
Hit it.
Okay, when life deals us cards, make everything taste like it's salt.
Get it. Flip it. You make it say, oh, sheesh.
Okay, when you put it in that context.
Context nothing, bro.
I was hearing, bro.
I was hearing them lyrics. I was hearing them lyrics,
but like, think about it.
Mix it, kiss it.
Once you change that, like,
she baby say, oh,
her vagina.
Sheesh. It's a vagina song. He probably bites it. He looks like a nigga to bite a clitoris.
Oh my god.
He probably put sugar in that bitch too.
But smoke a cigarette.
Yeah, bro.
PG 37. That pussy Dominican. Next track.
No.
Successful.
I just wanna be successful.
That's what I always think about when I read that word.
That's a hit.
Even in my classes.
You know a song's a hit when you just, oh man, you.
She like Mario.
Pause it. I'm getting too feminine for this bitch. Put some JB Blood Boy.
I'm growing a clitoris.
Hold on, nigga. Hold on.
I'm growing a clitoris.
Oh, shit. Oh, man. My facial hair is falling off.
This is a real deal. Pharrell is wow. That's nice. He found a pocket with her. That's crazy.
That song right there is like targeted to like suburban girls.
And it's about being successful, so it makes me feel like he said earlier, empowered.
I feel like an empowered young woman.
I let my clit hang.
A convertible with a chihuahua.
Yeah, you feel like that? I feel like I drive a Prius.
I feel like I gotta wear no bra, and I'm going to slut walk.
Shout out Emma Rose. I feel like the opposite. I feel like I want to go to like the work with men in Wall Street and be the strongest bitch in that bitch.
Next track, every time.
Bro,
these one word title tracks have been real love talking.
Oh man,
now we got this one called Breathing.
It's either sexual or love.
This one's gonna be sexual, has to be.
Breathing?
I'm talking about sex, bro.
Wow.
Things just take way too much of my energy. You take my cares away.
That's the one.
I've been feeling like this.
That's the one.
Oh,
I thought she was sparking.
I think I'm gonna put this in the nipples. straight up Hollister shit.
I don't know about Hollister. Never been there.
Bullshit.
Nigga, you were rocking that shit.
money.
Bullshit.
You
never walked in Hollister?
Never.
You never walked.
He had a middleman.
Never walked.
What do you got? A proxy?
Yes. Never. No, nor.
Oh, please. What do you used to get it online then?
What was the other one with the little power and shit
with the
like
coupon
that?
Codes.
What was the other one?
Abercrombie and Fitch?
That. Never.
You never walked into
nigga,
Hollister?
That shit was made for skinny people. I've always been a big nigga.
Think about it.
No, nigga, I've never wore that shit in
it's
my
true,
life.
It's true, nigga. It's true. Them niggas never kind of.
Yeah, they have tight shirts. They,
I always
nigga,
wear.
They're only tight shirts.
I always
nigga.
Wear. Shout out to my man right here,
I don't
Mr.
Think...
American Eagle.
Yeah, I was American Eagle.
That's what
that.
I used to wear.
Yes, for God.
I don't know Hollister.
When I was younger, man,
the
I used
car
to.
One, whatever the fuck it was.
Man, I used to just wear Buggle Boy. Song right here, man. It was
amazing.
It was
I like this track. This shit.
I had Jimmy like a little girl giggling.
Jimmy's alcoholic.
Black thought had to look the other way.
Oh Jimmy was up the heady that night.
Oh my God, bro.
You need help. You need help, bro.
You need help, bro. We'll talk.
Jimmy, we see you drowning.
All jokes aside.
Nobody wants to talk about it.
Nobody wants to tell the truth.
Nobody wants to tell the fucking truth. Yo, that's dramatic. That's, I'm gonna talk to Flex when I see him in person about that. Because that's historic in rap history.
When Tyrese did that shit.
Yo.
I'm at $13,000 a month. What more do you want from me?
He did it for a good cause. Like,
yeah, but, damn. Shout out to you, bro.
Fuck baby girl. Alright, I'm not gonna be funny, nigga.
What? Shrek, you guys saw our reaction to it. If you haven't, here's a clip.
Well, nigga, what? I'm vibing.
That's right. No tears left to cry.
Did you put the clip?
Yep, it's there.
The clip was put?
Yeah. No tears left to cry, man.
But did you put the clip?
The clip was put.
The clip was put in.
What the clip was.
Put the clip again.
Well, nigga, what? I'm vibing.
Put that clip.
Did you put the clip again?
Clip.
There we
clip.
Got it. That's the rewatch of the clip.
What no, did you put it again?
I think they got enough of the clip at this point.
Again?
Well, nigga, what? I'm vibing.
We got them niggas fully
loaded.
One
more time, one more
did
time.
Did you put the clip?
One
you
more time.
Clip? Are you sure you put the
bro,
clip?
Bro, put it mad time, nigga. Like, cutting off every, like, thing, nigga.
Yo. Did you put the clip, bro?
It was there. It's...
Well, nigga, what? I'm vibing.
Hey, it's there.
No tears left to cry. Do you guys have tears? Oh, sorry, it's touch your skin.
What are you talking about? Is that homosexual because you touched your boy?
Damn, bro. Y'all niggas making me blush, y'all. Sure, I got Missy Elliott, so it might be hard.
Oh, Missy.
Missy Elliott, one of the most impactful female artists of all time.
When I was younger, that was my crush. Oh, man. Oh, my God. What a sex symbol.
Yo.
It's a bigger woman, bro. She's very beautiful.
I had no idea she was on this album. That's
she's
amazing.
She's a beautiful woman. Nobody talks about her beauty.
No, yeah, she's
she
sexy.
Got styled ass.
She's
too.
Sexy. She's sexy.
She's stylish.
She's called beautiful. Borderline.
Woo! We got a vote to this shit.
Alright. Talking about being on her knees though. Got explicit real quick. Woof. Baby, you got me all on my knees. Whoa then, girl.
Is that what she said?
That's what she said, bro.
I don't remember hearing that.
Bro, what is going on?
I know it's hard to believe, but you got me all on my knees. I bet you won't ever leave. Once you tasted my ice cream.
Nah.
That's a sex song.
Nah.
It's hard to believe, but you got me all on my knees. Light it up, though. Okay, light it up, though.
Orgasm talk.
You not, I heard let it all come.
Listen, we gonna roll with it, I guess.
I kid you not, bro.
Pete, you're on your bag, I guess.
Meeting at the borderline, seems like I'm coming on strong. But I don't want this time to pass. I know you got a lot of chicks hollering at you.
Oh, she's dealing with Playboy niggas.
But I bet they get on last. Baby. You know I'm wifey type. What's good?
Well, once you tasted my ice cream, I bet you won't ever leave. I know it's hard to believe, but you got me
tall on my knees.
She wanna fuck a nigga, bro.
What is going on, though?
Can you imagine the one named after him?
Oh, we're getting there soon. I forgot his. Oh my god.
Next track is called Better Off.
Everything that we believed about her was a lie. She's out here, bro.
She wants to fuck on the roof.
Just to say that she did it.
I don't even think Nicki says that shit. Fuck on the roof just to say you did it?
Wow, bro. Who's she gonna tell? Petey boy! I feel like she likes the bad guys.
Nigga.
The bad guys? I like them tough guys.
She said, I just rather watch you smoke and drink.
You really consider that nigga tough, though?
That's what I'm trying to say. That nigga, bro, come on. Come on!
She wanna get with a gangbanger?
Bro, she wants DMX, bro, but DMX, is he locked up?
Man's a man, boy.
Yo.
Overalls and some Tims. Half of the overalls ain't on, though.
J-Rock is still out here. Yeah. Go for J-Rock.
This shit got me.
I heard the game is slanging.
Slanging that
YG's
dude.
Out here. Oh baby, what are you doing with Pete Davidson? She's like going out of what's expected of her.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's like she's growing up.
It's like she's going up.
Her way of doing it is different than like
Miley,
Katie, all these people. You see it like it's out in the open. She didn't go and get Migos on a track.
Yeah.
Bitch look like a fucking retard.
Listen, that shit was awful. We saw that shit live in action.
That bitch was on everything. Bitch was on everything.
Yo.
Looking crazy, bro. Who does that shit? Nigga, I feel embarrassed. Call my parents after that shit.
Mom, I did a mistake today.
She hasn't looked crazy. She didn't do that.
She hasn't looked crazy. You know what? You know what? I get.
Bitch. California girls is the shit, bitch. You lost yourself.
Sienna's done that in a pretty tasteful way, bro. It's just she's maturing. She's just getting older, bro. She doesn't want to be typecast anymore as this little girl. She does look very fucking young. This nigga's dying.
She's fucking young, bro. She's skinny as fuck.
Put the shark that was dancing in the NFL with her. There's the Super Bowl. Man. Out of her, bro. Because, she's getting into this live, blah, blah, smoking, drinking, whatever. But at least she's not out here.
We haven't seen it, too.
Yeah, we haven't seen it.
You know what I'm saying? We haven't seen it, so, you know what I'm saying? I think she got the proper team, the proper management. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Scooter Braun.
You can't have a meltdown because then you lose your core fans. And the core fans are not going to rock with you after you have a meltdown.
Exactly.
You know, and the core fans are the younger fans for you, baby.
She went the tasteful hip-hop route. She went almost the black IP route, the Pharrell route. It works.
Yeah.
It's tastefully done. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
And also, she's talking about sexuality and promiscuity, but not in an untasteful way.
Yeah. You just know, little hits
would
here
you
and there.
Consider it promiscuity, though? Because it's just, like...
Nigga, I would say so if you're fucking on the roof.
No, bro.
No. She's on her knees, bro.
Promiscuity, yes, promiscuity.
She's on her knees.
She's on her knees. You're talking about coming. She says coming like, very divisively. I'm not stupid. I've heard it several tracks. Coming instead of just you arriving or some shit. You know what I'm saying? Coming.
Yeah.
So she's very promiscuous in the way she's talking. She's very divisive. She's not stupid. She's, bro, she's a songwriter.
God's a woman.
She's in love, bro.
Yeah. Come on now. You know what I'm saying? Okay, she's in love. Good for you, baby. But all I'm saying is that you're doing it better than the other people have done it before you.
Next track, Good Night and Go. One track away from the Pete Davidson one.
Oh, yes. Are we stupid or dumb? We're not stupid or dumb.
She's saying all those sexual things.
Lately, all I want is you on top of me. Come on! You know where your hands should be. Oh shit! Man, I got you dreaming. You close your eyes and you're screaming. Play with your mind for no reason.
It's a porn album.
I know you love how I tease it.
Ooh, damn. You so just
so
this. My lips. I wonder who's in the studio with her recording. Mad porn stars.
Pete Davidson.
Mad porn stars.
Well, bro, because Pete Davidson.
It has to be a girl engineer. If it's just them two, her singing all them lyrics and a nigga is just engineering it up, you by himself, you
nigga
crazy.
Boner.
That nigga hard.
This is crazy.
Yo, Ari, you out here? She out here.
That's crazy. I was really expecting something like the first, like little track.
Yeah. It's gonna be a highlightable moment. Come exhibition. Here's the song that we all been waiting for. It's called Pete Davidson.
Oh my god.
Surprisingly, it's like a minute long though.
It's a minute long?
Yeah, but we're gonna break it down more.
I have some strong ass lyrics.
Come. Tits hard.
Oh my god. What is wrong?
Shout out to Pete Davidson doing big things with MGK.
Hated the most, so I keep my haters close. Let them know I want to smoke.
Looking like a fucking fool, bro.
My ass is at like that.
Oh, nah, you know.
My ass is shit like this.
Yeah, nah. He's a comedian. He can take it. You can't dish it if you can't take it, bro. You can't dish it if you can't take it. That's your girl, bro.
Bandana.
Oh my god. Your boy had to go to costume design to get a couple outfits.
Yo, that nigga went to the wrong neighborhood.
Wearing DC shit.
And he decides to dye his hair. That's the move.
Oh my god. Imagine he's from like the west side of Philly.
Oh man. He's like from Akron or some shit. I swear to god, I forgot who he said some shit like that. Whoa, I'm the swearer guy. All up on Jimmy Fallon looking crazy.
When I take a it's like a new.
Have I seen him before? Like
bro, SNL, bro.
So I nigga watch in the streets. SNL.
Hold up, though. Bro.
Where's Mac Miller's song?
Hmm?
Where's Big Sean's song? Hmm? Oh, okay. So he gets the title track.
Bro, and Mac is hard, too. Mac ain't the nigga to fuck with. Nigga, she fucked with rappers. And this is the hardest nigga.
Dark comic, man.
This is her tough guy. She's fucked with Big Sean from the Dirty. She's fucked with Mackie, boy. Bro, Mackie's dirty.
Nigga, he's literally might be dirty.
Bro.
Oh, get out of here, bro. Take that shit down. You're ruining my life.
The reason why we're talking about this is because we're so heartbroken. Because we love Mac Miller, man. And to see her not be with Mac,
it was so unexpected.
It was so unexpected.
But is it though?
Well,
because that's what your girls be doing. Unexpected things.
I don't really pay attention to it because that's how like you know these celebrities are. So I really don't. Like,
girls be scheming on downloads.
Really they be don't. Scheming, bro. 3 years in the making. I told my hairdresser that I'm gonna marry him one day, jokingly.
You know,
I be having crushes.
Ago. That was 3 years ago.
And three SNL, bro. Ago. First time she went to SNL, she said,
"Wow." And she was
backstage.
With Mackie.
Nasty, bro. She could have been with Big. She was with someone. That's the thing. That's crazy to me. No one's talking about it, though. We're gonna let her ride.
She was scheming on him, boy.
Scheming on him.
She was scheming on him.
Let's play the track and see if she talks about this shit.
I thought you under my light. Look in my mind. Are they aligned? You never must have my back. And they know you know that you miss all me and all that.
She wrote this song 3 weeks after meeting a nigga. This shit been plotting, bro. The song been plotting. The song's old.
When did you write this song?
Like a week after we started hanging out and stuff.
Yeah.
I just made it and I sent it to him. And I didn't know what to call it. So I just called it Beat.
After meeting him?
After meeting him.
Oh my god.
Let me see the lyrics.
Nah, nigga, you crazy though. So she was with Mac, but she had this song written about Pete Davidson?
That's weird, man. That's weird.
Nah,
That's some high school shit.
She was with Mac,
But she had this song written.
I'm gonna sing it because I'm a singer. Yeah. I'm not gonna sing it. I thought you into my life. Mm. Wow. Look at my mind. Yeah. No better place or time. Look how they align. Universe must have my back. Fell from the sky into my lap. And I knew you knew, and I know you, and I know you know.
Man, I fell into like concrete.
That you're my soulmate and all that. I'm like, ooh, my whole life got me ready for you.
Wow, them vocals on point, bro.
3 years of vocal lessons. Got me happy, happy. I'm happy. I'ma be happy. Won't get no crying from me. Aw, it's kind of sad.
This is real life, though.
This is kind of sad, bro. I don't even want to make fun of her anymore.
I'm not making fun of her, though. She's brave. Yeah. Because she's putting all this shit on display. Yeah. And it takes real shit, real artists to do that. Bro. Man. You know what I'm saying?
For her.
She's following her life right on her heart.
Oh, fuck.
But this shit hurts. Because we ain't girls. We're on the niggas' side. And on top of that,
we love
them niggas.
I don't really.
Not Pete. We love niggas.
What? What? Crazy, though. And then she eloped with Mac.
Didn't niggas almost get married or some shit?
I have no idea. I wasn't on them like that. But yo.
Just keep swimming.
Think about it. Imagine your girl is with you, right? And she goes out somewhere, whatever. She's doing some shit. She meets a nigga. And then she's like, ooh, wow, he got me so happy. I'm happy.
But I'm assuming it's like after she broke up with Mac and like started talking with this guy, no? It has
to
be like that. Come
what are
on.
You talking about? She met him 3 years ago, right?
She met him at SNL. I don't know.
It hurts me because damn, it's like I can't trust nobody now.
Nigga, that's crazy.
Fuck.
How does that fall into your life?
Nigga, it falls into my life because these bitches being scheming, bro! What's good though, nigga? Fuck!
He says, fucking kind of weird, blah, blah.
Because people say, oh, you're Ariana's boyfriend now. That's all they know him as. You know what I'm saying? Man. So he's saying, like, yeah, I guess it's awesome, but it's kind of weird. That's how you talk to her.
What was he expecting for them to be like, oh, fuck. You're...
Pete Davidson, you're the MGK guy, right? You're the one that's the MGK videos, right?
Hated the most, so I keep my haters close. Let them know I want to smoke.
Nigga. You're the hard ass, right?
Nigga.
You're the one that's out in the streets, right?
And like the thing about him too, is like he's not even like a highlightable guy in SNL. He says it himself, nigga. He's like the plan B in SNL. Like they use him for like small little things.
Wasn't he on MTV?
Doing what?
On MTV? What do you mean?
I've seen him because I don't watch SNL.
Probably Wild and Out.
So I've seen him somewhere.
Probably Wild and Out.
Probably MTV.
He's been a while, I feel like. Yeah. He's like a Wild
It was a very good rhyme. It was very clever. I left 4 years ago, but you'll be stuck here forever.
Wild and Out guy.
Yeah, yeah, I'm white, but I rap too. You got some whack shoes.
I make fun of you, bro, because you're a comic and you can take it.
Yeah. If you can't take it, bro.
Don't be a comic.
Get out the kitchen, bitch.
But.
You're in the wrong kitchen.
But on a personal note, it does affect us because we don't know what's really going on. But from the outside point of view, it is like, wow, like, she was plotting on Mac.
And Mac hasn't said shit. He's a gentleman. He's the cool. Swimming. I'm gonna drop this album swimming. Mac good, whatever, do my thing. I could have blasted you, baby. I could have made a number one song in the country by blasting you. But I kept my cool.
But I'll tell you this much.
It's a man's man.
Yeah, he said it too, bro. He was like, yeah, I'm not with her. What's good? Like, it is what it is. He's not disappointed about it.
Listen, bitch, ain't nobody talking to you.
Oh, that's crazy.
That's how Max should have been with Ari, but he kept his cool. You know what I'm saying? He even called a bitch one time. Never. Back on the album, Get Well Soon, is Tyler Crater's favorite song, supposedly.
Tyler loves his album.
He loves the chords.
Yeah, he's a chord guy.
Ballad from Ariana right there. Young Money.
Is it 40 seconds of silence then?
Yeah.
There we have it.
That was kind of
Sweetener. You know what I'm saying? Ariana Grande, one of the best voices right now. And Pharrell Williams, one of the best producers right now. You know what I'm saying? You got what you kind of expected from it here and there. But I don't know. It had its moments. It definitely had its moments.
It had its moments.
Yeah.
I feel like it was kind of bittersweet.
Maybe it's kind of Sweetener. That was the point. What's going on?
Because there was some tracks that I really, like, fucked with. And then, like I said, the other ones, I just felt like it could have been better. I don't know. Like I said, when I think about her, I'm expecting going crazy. These vocals, like the first track, you feel me? That's just me. I don't know.
I think the content, what she was saying, was very, very... Like, we paid attention to it a lot.
Yeah.
Because it was so, like, left field, I felt
it's
like.
It's really different from her past.
Yeah.
Though.
So, she has a new approach now. She's in love. You can clearly see it. We're not going to make fun of that. It's just, he's kind of.
Do you think, my mom?
Fucking, he's kind of. The situation was kind of funny, and that's it. But I don't. We really don't care. It isn't.
Think, baby.
But do you think, girl? I want to know how her core fans relate to this.
Yeah.
That's weird.
I want to know how the core fans relate to it. I want to know the reaction. I want to see the critical acclaim, if it gets any. Musicality, what's the reviews? What are people talking about it? You know what I'm saying? I know that
Reason
Tyler...
was a hell of a track.
Yeah.
Tyler loved it
for some reason, you know what I'm saying?
Damn.
I think it's because of that reason. The voice, one of the best voices, and then you got one of the best producers. There's going to be little moments.
There's going to be little moments. Also, like, it also very, like, female-oriented.
Like, the only way you can really hate on it is, like, oh, I don't like the lyrics.
Bro, but fuck that shit. You know what it is? I don't think niggas is really going to listen to this. I don't think any guy is like, oh, I got to listen to this Ariana.
He's not listening to this.
But because it makes... I think this is directed towards females. And not only females, like, bro, like... It's made me feel like a girl at times.
It's a soft album.
Soft?
You know, it's soft, but it's sweet. You feel me?
But not that, bro. It's like, it's not that sweet. Not too sweet.
It's not even that. I don't know what it is. It's just,
she's like sativa.
Bro.
What's that sugar that's not sugar?
Splenda.
I said sativa. I think sativa
is
weed.
A strand of weed.
That's weed. I'm sorry.
You try not to give in to fear because obviously that's the whole point of being here. That was the point of finishing my tour. It was to set an example for my fans who were fearless enough to show up to the f***ing shows. Like, are you kidding? You know, you want to set the same example and you want to keep going. And-